opinions.
And they're either all the way for me or all the way against me. There were very few years throughout his life where he wasn't heavily involved with processes and things in Israel. He was always believing that he made the right choices, the right moves throughout his life as a politician and as a soldier. I think we're going in the right way. We have to stick to it. We should not stay away from it. We have to bring everybody together and stop the violence, and even with the violence, I will still go on. Rabin started as a fighting soldier. Rabin has prepared the army to the war and to the victory, the greatest victory we had back in 67. He was the chief of staff in the Six Days War. And one of the slogans he could not accept was people calling him recently a traitor, blaming him that it in treason to the country. What do you mean a traitor? I've never traded anybody.
הוא שב לכאן עם פרוץ מלחמת יום הכיפורים באוקטובר 73, מלחמה שמחזירה לו הרבה טראומות של שדה קרב שחשב כי בתור אזרח כבר הותיר מאחוריו.
הייתה אווירה ממש קשה.
It was a heavy atmosphere during 73. And I said, give me a cigarette, and I stopped 3 years of non-smoking.
בעקבות מסקנות ועדת אגרנט, הוא נבחר להיות ראש הממשלה, הצבר הראשון של מדינת ישראל.
He was the first prime minister who was actually born in Israel until the government has collapsed over the argument about his wife's account in the U.S. bank account.
מלחמת יום הכיפורים, גילוח השכבה הבחירה של מפלגת העבודה, והייתי חבר כנסת.
I was a member of the parliament for 6 months.
סך הכל, כשנכנסתי לתפקיד ראשות הממשלה.
Until I became a prime minister.
אבל לא הייתי בשביל הג'ונגל הפוליטי.
But I wasn't prepared for the political jungle. In February of 92, after being the Secretary of National Security, the whole party united behind the slogan, Israel is waiting for Rabin. The slogan has proved itself. And after 15 years, Rabin has come back to the Prime Minister office. I will be the one to determine who the other secretaries of state will be, and there will not be any argument about it.
על התהליך הזה, שלפחות בימים אלה, בימים שעדיין הוא מתנהל ואנו חשים אותו על בשרנו, יום יום, שעה שעה, לטוב ולרע,
this process that we feel every day, every hour, we should not talk about too much.
That we would have reached this great moment without the desire for peace in the hearts of both peoples.
Peace! העובדות ידועות,
the facts are known. It is only the way we regard them that move from one opposition to the other. Demonstrators calling Rabin a traitor. Reflecting back, everybody is going to ask themselves, how could we detect what came to be true, what came to be a reality? I wrote a sticker, a bumper sticker, out of anger. I've never thought too much about it. But all the bumper stickers and the traitor cries and the opposers never fazed him. Calling for better education of the people, he said, I don't care about the demonstrators. This was a few weeks ago, and this was last night. And among all the hundreds of thousands of people, last night there was one that got in and did the depictable thing.
יכול יצחק רבין להירגע, שרוח חדשה מעודדת ומניעה אותו, דווקא אז הכל נגמר.
In an emotional hour.
Absolutely, absolutely.
You've been watching Israel's Channel 2 here on CNN World Report. We are grateful and indebted to Channel 2. Also, our thanks to Jacob Elon and Ashrut Kotler, the anchors of Channel 2.
Our broadcaster, yes. Channel 2 in Israel. In our second hour, as we look at the Middle East and beyond in the aftermath of Yitzhak Rabin's assassination, we'll get reaction from a broad array of international broadcasters from their perspective. Stay with us.